Our third option, which is kind of like our Geheimtipp, because not everybody knows about this, but that is the Zwangsversteigerung. Okay, so here's the deal, guys. I actually just filmed a video going through 5 different stages of finding your property, financing your property, contacting the seller, actually going through all of the paperwork and making all of the payments. So from start to finish. However, that video ended up being over 40 minutes long. So what I've decided to do is actually break them into 2 components. This video is going to be featuring the actual initial stages of finding that property, financing that property, and then contacting the seller. So that pre-sale. If you would like to know how to find a smart investment property here in Germany, then continue to watch this video. If you would like some more tips going more in depth into the extended process, then you can either go over to my part 2 of this video, which is actually buying the property and the steps that you need to take in order to do so. Otherwise, you can go to our all-rounder video that also gives you some tips on a really great company that allows you to properly analyze a deal to make sure that it is the right deal and the smartest property investment for you. So the first step is actually finding a property that is a smart investment choice. There are multiple ways that you can find properties. My husband and I really, really love, of course, eBay Kleinanzeigen. We also really like ImmoScout. And our third option, which is kind of like our Geheimtipp, because not everybody knows about this, but that is the Zwangsversteigerung. So this is actually an auction of houses, of property here in Germany. I would say between the 3, the Zwangsversteigerung or the auction, you're going to have the best bet at getting a property that is probably renovierungsbedürftig, which means you're going to have to really, really renovate it, but you're really usually going to get the best bang for your buck in this case. eBay Kleinanzeigen is a really good one if you're looking at saving a little bit of money, because a lot of time personal sellers are there. They choose not to use a Makler or a real estate agent in English, and that might save you a little bit on the fees in the long run. Sometimes people also end up selling their property a little bit undervalued than you might see on ImmoScout, because on ImmoScout, of course, private sellers can also upload their properties. However, a lot, if not most of them, are offered by the real estate agent. So ImmoScout is also a great option, as I said. That's probably where you're gonna find the bulk of the properties and find the most success. But I wouldn't forget about the auction opportunity or, of course, also checking on eBay Kleinanzeigen. So the first thing you're gonna have to think of when you're investing in real estate here in Germany is if you want to purchase a house or just an apartment. So Eigentumswohnung or an apartment would be part of the Wohnungseigentumgemeinschaft, which means you're also going to be paying monthly, if not annual, fees to maintain the actual building itself. I would say as an investment property, if you're looking to rent it out, makes probably more sense to actually buy the entire property on your own or to buy an entire house. If you want to buy this property for yourself, well, then it might actually make sense because you're going to be there and you're going to be seeing this maintenance take place and understand exactly what's happening with your money within this communal pot of money for renovations and repairs and upkeep. A good tip here, and what my husband and I always look out for, is properties that actually make sense, that are actually bringing you money in even before you pay off the mortgage. It might sound a little bit strange, but my rule to him, because he looks every single day, is that we cannot purchase this property unless it pays the mortgage off itself and some. Of course, it's not easy to find this and it's not always going to be the case, but if it's possible, of course, this is even better for you because you are actually going to get rent from people in this house and then pay off the mortgage right away. So this is actually the case with our new property, so much so that we were making a couple $100 extra each month that we're now able to put into hiring a property manager, which makes things very easy because this property is actually 40, 45 minutes away from us. Another good thing to mention is in Germany, location is really everything. And coming from North America, this is a little bit different because people don't mind getting in their car and driving somewhere to get to school or the grocery store. But in Germany, because, you know, there's so many people and it is not such a massive country, there's a lot more opportunity to walk to school, to walk to the grocery store, to walk to a Naturschutzgebiet, you know, a nature reserve. There are a lot more opportunities here. So when purchasing a property, it probably makes more sense to make sure that you check all of these things off your boxes before actually going to see the property or to make an offer on the property, unless, I mean, it's a steal of a deal, but this is always something you should really look into, especially if you're planning on renting it out or reselling it soon. One last thing that I will mention, and that is super, super important to consider, is this Bodengrundwert, or I'm not sure the actual terminology in German, but the actual value of the land that the property stands on. There is a website in Germany called Boris, and I will actually link that down below for you guys to check out. But basically, you can put in an address and figure out exactly what the land itself is worth that the house stands on. So a good rule of thumb, if the property being sold is being sold at ground value, well then you've probably got yourself a really good deal. If it's a little bit more, then you also have to see, okay, well, how much is the house actually worth? Is it renovated? Does it need to be teared down? Because of course, if it needs to be teared down, then that's an added cost on top of the actual value of the land. So you want to make sure that you're paying value of land or even a bit less because the additional costs it's going to take to actually rip the property down. So your next step would be financing, finding the money to actually be able to purchase this property or finding that mortgage. There are a number of ways to find a bank that will offer you a mortgage here in Germany. You can actually compare your options online. There are multiple sites. I will link some down below for you to check out. However, my absolute hands down favorite is definitely LoanLink. That's because they're English. And for me, I think it's something that's really, really tough for internationals to kind of comprehend and to realize, oh my God, you know, we can actually buy a property here in Germany. There are no legal restrictions blocking us from doing so. The biggest thing is actually the language barrier, right? So LoanLink allows you to take that first step. It's super, super simple. You plug in all your information, they figure out which mortgages are available for you. It costs you no additional funds, no additional money, because they're actually making that money through affiliates. And that's not to say that they're only giving you, you know, the ones where they're making the most affiliate money off of. You have so many different choices to choose from. You can also do it in German as well, but I just wanted to make that note specifically for the non-German or non-native German speakers watching this video today, because this will definitely, definitely help you out. Typically, you're looking at a down payment of about 10 to 20% of the actual worth of the sale. I would say if you're lucky or if you've bought in property before, we actually got the opportunity from our bank to pay no money down. That usually means you have to offer some sort of collateral. So they said, okay, well, we want your first house as collateral and then we'll give you the mortgage with no money down to actually pay off your second house. You should also be prepared that the bank might actually also do an audit on that house, whether they're just doing it online to check the worth of the land that the property stands on itself, or they want to actually come and see the property themselves. This could always take place. In our case, with our two investments, nobody did any audit, and that was simply because the purchase that we made was actually less than the value of the land that the property stands on. So we got very lucky. And your mortgage typically lasts between 10 and 15 years. It could be a little bit longer. It's not usually less than 10 years, but it's just, of course, who's to say? It depends on how big of the mortgage that you're getting. But yeah, typically between 10 to 15 years with a fixed interest. And I say that because it is very, very important that you get something with a fixed interest, because of course, if they're going to be changing the interest model on you halfway through, well, then you could be paying a lot more interest in the future. So I would say it's pretty important to be able to accept an offer on a mortgage with fixed interest. This part can typically be rather overwhelming, and that's because there's a lot of numbers, there's a lot of things you need to consider, there are a lot of things that you're gonna have to pay for. I will go into detail about this, but that you're gonna have to pay land tax, you're gonna have to pay to be entered in the Grundbuch, you're gonna have to pay the real estate agent, there are a lot of fees that you're gonna have to pay. So you need to kind of do the math and figure it all out. Does this purchase make sense? That is all for me. I hope that you really enjoyed this video. If you would like to know the additional stages to actually purchasing a property here in Germany, as I mentioned, you can go check out part two. I will link that right up here for you. If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, wie immer, vielen, vielen lieben Dank und bis später.